My name is Anita Vasudevan, and I'm a fourth-year medical student here at the University of Michigan. I'm also a certified yoga instructor. When I was a first-year student studying musculoskeletal anatomy, I found that using yoga was an intuitive and practical way to engage with the material. This video series is based on that concept, and I hope that you'll find this as engaging and fun as I did to study. The whole thing is based around the basic biomechanic concept that as muscles shorten or concentrically contract, they enact movement over a joint. For example, let's take a look at the biceps muscle. You can go ahead and place your left hand on your right biceps, and you'll notice that as the muscle flexes and gets shorter, we have flexion of the forearm at the elbow. We'll also use our skeleton friend and a scarf to depict the same concept. Placing the scarf across the attachments of the muscle, for example, the biceps. As the scarf shortens, showing concentric contraction of the biceps, there is flexion of the forearm at the elbow. I recommend watching these videos in a place where you have room to move, wearing comfortable clothes, and getting out a yoga mat if you have one. I also suggest watching these videos in order, since the content continues to build on itself. As we move through more muscle groups, we will continually review material from previous videos as it relates. Before we begin, let's do a quick review of the basic movements of joints at the lower and upper extremity that we talk about in these videos. So let's start at the hip. The hip is a ball and socket joint and is responsible for 7 different movements. So the first major movement of the hip is flexion. This is flexion of the thigh at the hip. Next is extension, coming back to anatomical position, and then extending the thigh at the hip, coming back to neutral. Abduction with a B is where the thigh moves away from midline. Adduction is where the thigh moves back towards midline at the hip. And finally, we have lateral rotation, where we have the hip joint turning out. And so this is rotation of the entire leg at the hip. And then we have medial rotation, where the hip rotates inward. And as you can see, my toes and knees are now pointing towards midline. Finally, we have circumduction, where the hip moves in a circle. Next, we have the knee joint, which is a hinge joint. Hinge joints primarily only have 2 different movements. At the knee, that looks like flexion of the leg at the knee. And as you can see, my hip is still steady, so the flexion is moving only the lower leg. And then we have extension of the leg at the knee. And most people's knees come to about 180 degrees, not usually past that. And so when we're standing, our lower leg is already extended at the knee. Moving down to the ankle or the talocurl joint, we also have a hinge joint. Here we have dorsiflexion, where the toes point in towards the body. And then we have plantar flexion, where the toes point down towards the ground. You can remember that plantar flexion is like planting your toes on the ground. Moving from the lower extremity up to the upper extremity, a lot of the joints are analogous. So at the shoulder, we have a ball and socket joint, much like the hip. We can have flexion of the arm at the shoulder. We can have extension of the arm at the shoulder, moving back. Coming back to midline, we have abduction, moving the arm away from midline. We have adduction, moving the arm back towards midline. And we have lateral rotation, where keeping the elbow close to the body, I'm turning my shoulder outwards. And we have medial rotation, where the shoulder turns inwards. Moving from the shoulder down to the elbow, just like the knee, is a hinge joint, but it's a modified hinge joint. It has a little bit more mobility. So at the elbow, we can have flexion of the arm at the elbow, or we can have extension of the arm at the elbow. Coming down to the wrist, we have a condyloid joint. The wrist is also known as the radiocarpal joint. So starting at anatomical position, we can have flexion of the wrist, of the hand at the wrist. We can have extension of the hand at the wrist. We can have abduction, moving the hand away from midline, or adduction, moving the hand in towards midline. The wrist can also do circumduction, where it can move in a full circular movement. These movements are easy enough to understand when we're talking about them from anatomical position. But what gets a little bit trickier is understanding which movements are happening at which joints as we go through different daily movements or through different yoga poses. So now I'll have you join me in downward facing dog, and we'll get a sense of what it's like to dissect the different movements of the pose. So to get into downward facing dog, You can make your way onto your mat or towel or blanket, wherever you are. And you'll start off in a tabletop pose, shoulders over the wrists, hips over the joint, hips over the knees. Go ahead and tuck your toes under and then let the hips lift up towards the sky. As the hips lift up, you can really push the ground away from you with the hands, really thinking about pressing down through the fingertips to feel the shoulders pulling back and to feel the neck and the head release. You'll let the gaze go down in between the legs. If you turn your head from side to side, the gaze should be underneath the arms. And from here, in downward facing dog, we see that we have the wrists in extension. We have extension of the forearms at the elbow. We have flexion of the arm at the shoulder. We have extension of the leg at the knee. And we have dorsiflexion of the ankles, especially as the heels reach back further towards the earth. If you'd like here, you can take a nice full deep inhale, feeling the ground press even further away from you, feeling a nice release in your low back. And on the exhale, you can let the knees drop back down to the ground and let the hips sink back onto the heels, coming back to a seated position. As we close out this introduction, I'd like to emphasize the point that reviewing anatomy through yoga needs the participant to be really aware of different nuances of movements in the body. In order to begin cultivating this awareness, I'd like to start with a short guided meditation. You can find the seated position that's comfortable for you. And wherever you are, you can place your hands on your knees. Palms can be facing down towards the ground if you'd like to ground into the earth a little more. You can let the palms face up to the sky if you'd like to let yourself open up to what's around you. You can start off by just closing the eyes and paying attention to the different places that your body is in contact with the earth right now. Maybe noticing where the sit bones are grounding. Noticing where the soles of the feet are resting. And from here, wherever you're touching the ground, starting to draw length. Feeling the rise of the length of the low back from the hips. Maybe even lifting the shoulders up to the ears, just rolling them around back and down a couple times. Noticing the chest and the shoulders open up. And when you feel ready, you can guide your attention to the breath, noticing the flow of the next inhale as it comes in through the nose. Notice it fill up the belly, open up the chest. And on the exhale, let it out through the mouth, feeling that full collapse, release of everything you're holding in. Another really full inhale, deep breath in through the nose. Just watching this journey, you don't have to force its length. Exhale, let it go. Pressing it out through the mouth. One more time, really full inhale in through the nose. Lengthening, letting it nourish the whole body. Exhale, let it go out through the mouth. Sealing the lips. Starting to breathe exclusively in and out through the nose. Just letting yourself be aware of the movement of the breath. Watching each individual cycle. Maybe counting for the length of the inhale, up to four. Counting the length of the exhale, out to four. Noticing the very slight movement that happens through the upper body with each breath. Just noticing what comes in and out with each breath. It's totally natural to have other thoughts occasionally pop in. When this happens, you can notice them, paying attention to their presence. Maybe watch them float by, let them release the same way they came in. and gently guide your own attention back to the subtle movement, the presence, the cycle of each breath. Continuing for as long as you'd like. But when you feel ready, you can start to add in a little movement of your own, maybe with the next inhale, lengthening even more, letting the shoulders pull back. And with the exhale, letting the chin tip down towards the chest, just a really gentle neck stretch, letting the neck roll around to the right side, roll it around and back, over to the left, then back down. Gently opening the eyes whenever you're ready with the gaze down at the ground. And when you're ready, you can make your way over to the next video.